Welcome to another Live at Cthulhu Caverns. With your host, Dirty B. Where we talk about whatever the fuck we please.
Where real bars matter, and if you ain't coming with your A-game, get the fuck on. This ain't being this bitch. Cthulhu Caverns.
Yo, we are back in effect.
Facts.
It's not live, but it's Cthulhu Caverns.
It is not live, but it is still the vibes.
It is. It actually is new vibes. And now it sounds even better in here, nice and crisp. That's okay. You don't hear my voice bouncing off of the posters. Yeah, so it's fun. We are fucking back as you can be.
In full effect.
I'm back like Nicki Minaj.
Ooh, yeah.
Speaking of, shout out to her cousin's boyfriend's balls. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully the swelling goes down.
Make some noise for his balls.
Biggest balls in Trinidad.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, it's been too long, man. It's been fucking too long. I've missed this. Unfortunately, I don't have the fans in here fucking hitting the comments up, so it's going to be a little different, but... We do got some things to say, so let's start this off proper. We're going to start this off with, so everybody's pretty much working on some shit, you know what I'm saying? Bearded Weirdos, we dropped our debut album the end of last year, and then this year we started it up hot with Esoteric, The Meadow of Bones, then Lethal Dose. And since we're on the Cthulhu Caverns, I guess you get to hear it here. Keep your ear glued to the ground, because in October, before Halloween, you're going to hear a new single, and it's going to be for the holidays. And I'm pretty sure Tragic, fucking Skylo, Saint B, everybody's dropping something for Halloween.
Well, let's get to the real topic at hand. Dynamic Night dropped a new album, Numb Yourself to Emotion. October 5th, it dropped all platforms. Let's go.
Tis out there. Would you like to play something?
I would love to play something.
Let's see. Engineer's pick.
Yeah, because we can't ask the fans this time.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. But we are...
I know the crowd pleasers, though.
We are here. I almost want to give you guys this thing for this video, but we ain't going to do that because we got something to talk about there, too. Oh, shit. I guess I'll play the one I'm on, huh?
Yeah, might as well.
All right, this is League of My Own, y'all. Featuring moi.
Hey, Dirty. I told you I'm numb to emotion, bruh. I had to make the whole world feel the same way. Let me talk to him. I live by the code. I stick to the script. The cloth that I made from no longer exists. What y'all know about real? Cause y'all are not it. Me and the fraudulent cannot coexist. League of my own. I stand alone, solo. Besides the team, the squad, the niggas I knew from the cold, from the gold. League of my own, league of my own. I stand alone, solo. Play in the background, still front on every rapper you know. Hey, league of my own, I'm in my zone, writing lyrics in the studio. All in, I don't never fold. If it's about money, I pick up the phone. Other than that, not the chatty type. Wanna give my kids a better life. You claim you a fan of my music, but can't rap a verse I write. Call them out. Shots fired, haters wanna see me retire. I ain't even reached my peak yet. Been a threat with this rap shit. Versatile, spit it off the top. You can't get no bars, you ain't got the guap. Nothing in life is free.
Hey, I'm
gon' pay that fee. I know my worth, I stay down. My come up is right now. Them rappers had they play, now it's my buffet. I'm gonna eat, so is my team. High luck making money, while the ones I'm with daily struggle to make ends meet. Boxing. I stay by the cold, I stick to the strip. The cloth that I made from no longer exists. What y'all know about real? Cause y'all are not it. Me and the fraudulent cannot coexist. League of my own, hey. I stand alone, solo. Besides the team, the squad, the niggas I knew from the cold, from the gold. League of my own,
league of my own.
I stand alone, solo. Lay in the background, still front on every rapper you know, hey. I live by the cold, soda for toll. Play my position, watch it unfold. Shaking the dice, letting them roll. Hands in my blood, I'm letting it blow. I'm from the era of shoebox stash, corner store posted on the app. Blood burning every night, ducking red and blue lights. You don't know the half. Got a pocket full of dead prayers, and the day could've been dead. Couldn't let it go to my head. Had to stay alert, niggas creep in. Folks dove off the deep end. I was trying to stay afloat.
Huh?
Greed breeds jealousy, and both forget your smoke. This is
the trenches. Don't get caught without protection. Youngest killer died so reckless. No regrets for the actions. Damn shame, we need change. Need to put down the guns. Throw hands like a real man. Anyone can shoot. Look,
I live by the code. I stick to the script. The cloth that I made from no longer exists. What y'all know about real? Cause y'all are not it. Me and the fraud just cannot coexist. League of my own. I stand alone, so low. Besides the team, the squad, the niggas I knew from the code, from the gold. League of my own, league of my own. I stand alone, so low. In the background, still front on every rapper you know.
None of you coming in close to the league of my own, and I'm lost on the warpath. Some of you pray that the storm pass. Me, I'm just bringing the forecast. Never been one to complain, but look at the garbage you got in this game. Stay in your lane, league of my own, that's where I'm at. Bringing the pain. Nobody speaking the truth. All of their music is nothing but fabrications. Facts, them haters never captivate you. They ain't that amazing. If you live by the code, we killing you rappers and stepping away again. What you been saying is really sedating, and we gonna wake them all up and you facing it. Now that we bringing some paper and people are paying attention to bracing it, this is some dangerous. No one can play with us, leaving you blank inside like an atheist. We are the patriots, up in your radius. You can debate with us, but they evading us, acting the shadiest. Give them a love, we bringing the greatest, and no one debating it.
I live by the code. What? I stick to the script. The cloth that I made from no longer exists. What y'all know about real?
Not a damn
thing. Cause y'all are not it. Me and the fraudulent cannot coexist.
Yep.
League of my own. Hey. I stand alone, so low. Besides the team, the squad, the niggas I knew from the toe. From the go. League of my own. League of my own. I stand alone, so low. Lay in the background, still front on every rapper you know. Hey. I live by the code.
Yeah, but he doesn't stand alone necessarily. He doesn't necessarily do it solo either.
Nah, I don't.
Weed is so quiet, you never hear us coming.
But what the point was to that track.
Oh, no, I got that point.
Oh, I know.
I got the point.
And obviously, you know, you could hear it from the song, but, like, bro, nobody
just on a different
touching
level.
My nigga dirty when it comes to production on our wavelength.
Nah.
If you're doing it with the budget that we are, I'm not saying if you're in a big studio.
Shit, I ain't trying to toot my horn too hard, but we do it better than some people with bigger budgets.
Exactly. Bro, like,
matter of fact, shout out to my dude Tragic, man. I love Tragic, bro.
Tragic, bro.
Tragic, one of the few that actually is fucking good.
Salute my nigga Weed too.
And he hit me with the
Village about to pop off. I know what's up.
He hit me with the nerdest fucking compliment ever, and it was like one of my favorite. He thought I had hardware.
That's a fact. He did. Yeah, he said that.
Dope.
Yeah,
shit.
I was there. I was present.
If I could do it all in the box, and he thinks some of it actually has had a boost.
I'll tell y'all something that a lot of people don't know about Trash. That dude is way too humble for what he do.
Yeah, he is. You know what?
Too humble for what he do.
We went over there. We went to the crypt. We went over to his studio.
We sure went to the crypt.
I got
and shut it down.
Yeah, I got the rap on my favorite microphone on the planet.
Dope. Shout out Trash for, like, even giving us the inspiration to,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying, create something.
It was a mind of fuck, or it was a room full of minds spinning, bro.
It was four-headed dragon in that bitch.
Dog, and then it just came out right. And it was actually the longest I ever seen Skylar with his nose in the paper.
Yeah, it took him a little longer. Yeah,
when you're surrounded by motherfucking legends and OGs, your ass got to step your game up, you know,
like,
what I'm saying?
Yo. I mean, not even to toot my own horn about nothing, but yo, where we at now compared to where we was at then, it ain't no, you know what I'm saying? We had to show and prove, so everybody gotta, they gotta have their grind and they, you know.
Speaking of the boy, fucking Skylo, some of you may know Solo Flex. I'm not sure if he was around before Cthulhu Caverns took a crash, but him and Skylo have thrown their eggs in the same baskets, per se. They go by Carpe Demos, and so far so good. I mean, you know, Solo Flex is still up and coming. He's still under training, but he's developing quick. I mean, he's definitely got. Don't we all have a long way to go? But yeah, he's showing real promise. But you know how it is, man. In the beginning, it's a little rough, but it seems like every track he gets better and better. So that's a good thing. And you know, Skylo. He came a long way from when he first came around. You know, that boy was shy and timid, didn't make a lot of sense with his music, wasn't, like, confident in his voice. Now all those things could be said in opposite fashion. So, you know, we build motherfuckers around here, you know what I'm saying? You could come here with a dope set of skills and leave here a master. You know what I'm saying? Steel sharpens steel. And, you know, Knight, he's like the A&R of the label. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't even know it yet. You know what I'm saying? He brought so many people together. He's responsible for us going to the crypt. He set that shit up a long time ago.
I try to recognize greatness in all the people around me, and I show people my vision. You know what I mean? OTR. It's on the rise. You know what I mean? It's never been a label. It's always been about a movement. What are you doing? You know what I'm saying? You on the rise. If you working like we working, you on the rise. Because I'm telling you, it's blood, sweat, and tears over here. We've dragged our fucking knuckles and been broke for weeks and weeks to make some shit happen. You know what I'm saying? Cash apping each other.
And look,
when niggas ain't have nothing. You know what I mean? We was down and out, bro. Like, on our dick type shit. Like,
well, look, 2020 was a real proving time.
Oh, yeah.
Because we started off with Yo Mama's Favorite Rappers, which was like 19 deep.
Yeah.
A month later, we were 10 deep. A couple months later, we were like
five,
back to normal again.
Yeah.
Didn't even need a name for that shit.
Yeah. But, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, even with that, you know what I'm saying? Everything that we was pushing then, we was sharpening steel.
Yeah.
You know, steel sharpening steel.
And not to mention, I mean, everybody has their own little fucking funk. You know what I'm saying? Everybody goes through their own shit. And it just so happened to be one of the shittiest years, if not the shittiest year in existence. And everybody had their plates full, so it wasn't like nobody from Yo Mama's Favorite Rappers are necessarily beefed out. That's if you hear rumors going around,
like, look,
squash that shit.
For the record, like, let's just get it out the way, like, cause I know a lot of us ain't talk. Like, I fuck with everybody, bro, that fuck with me. You know what I mean? If I feel real genuine support from you, I'm gonna fuck with you. If it lacks at some point in time, I just reciprocate with energy. You know what I mean? Like, whatever energy you giving us, that's what you getting back.
Oh, and by the way, that lady in the corner is not a poster. That's Danny D's.
Oh, that's
bro.
Danny D's. D's nuts, nigga. Nah, I'm just playing.
No, future management, future promotion.
She's actually head of Crispy Films Productions. Crispy,
right? It's
visuals.
It's about to be on and popping. We're trying to do bigger things. And look, the more the merrier. The more people that can come to the circle with great ideas and have focus and drive, the farther along the entire mission is going to go. So,
I want to make it a point to get us our flowers. Like, I don't want no one giving them to us.
Well,
go get ours. Well, you know what I mean? I go pick up the goddamn bouquet myself.
So, like, Danny, before you came into the fold, how much experience did you have behind the scene with musicians and artists?
None, really.
Did you ever think that we could actually be such fucking faggots and cool? You know what I'm saying? Like, usually a lot of band members or rappers, they're egotistical as fuck. You know what I'm saying? And they're hard to be around. Take it from me, I know.
Yeah, a lot of like, that vibe doesn't happen over here at all.
But I can imagine that that's what you probably thought of all of us before you came around.
Yeah, a little bit. Like,
we can't blame you.
You know, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's how it is, man. And, you know, being stuck around us, we fouled her mouth all the way up. She is a sailor now.
Yo, she be driving, talking twats. And
look at this fucking dick bag, son of a bitch. Yeah, I bet your fucking kids are impotent.
Yeah.
I have used the term dog shit.
Oh, dog shit. Hey, shout out to Joe Rogan for the dog shit. Because, I mean, you can still take human shit, strain it out, and get some nutrients out of it.
Let's start with that topic, since you said my guy's name.
Okay,
Joe Rogan, bro.
Dog.
Listen. They literally fake news my nigga in the sickness.
All right, maybe not everybody knows the whole situation, so I'm going to break it down as quick as possible. Joe Rogan was going to get the vaccine. The UFC had allocated a certain amount of them, and he showed up to the UFC on Friday night for the show. And after the show, he was going to get his dose, but then they're like, oh, yeah, because of Vegas guidelines, you have to do it at a hospital. He's like, okay, well, I can't tonight, so I'll be back next Monday. So, before that Monday rolls around, Johnson & Johnson gets pulled for blood clots. So he's like, I guess I'm not taking that vaccine. And then shortly after this, he catches COVID. And he's had CDC experts and nutrition experts and doctors. I'm talking about handfuls, like 21 or 23 of them since the pandemic started on there, that know what the fuck they're talking about. And they've had 3-hour conversations with all of them. And they basically just highlighted medicines that have been helping and that have been, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, Joe Rogan's not an anti-vaxxer by any means. But so his doctor threw monoclonal antibodies at it. vitamin NAD drips, and then, of course, ivermectin, which we'll probably get pulled off of YouTube for even saying. But they called it a horse dewormer. Now, there is a version of ivermectin that is a horse dewormer.
But that's not what he
took. That's not what he took. He took the human version, which the...
He says, I can afford people's medicine.
I can afford people's medicine, motherfucker. No, so ivermectin has cured river blindness. That's not a thing anymore because of ivermectin.
Someone won a Nobel Prize for it.
Yeah, one of the creators got a Nobel Prize for it because of the river blindness and dengue fever and yellow fever and a bunch of other ones. And
shout out good medicine.
So I guess at a certain dosage, per a milligram per whatever kilogram, you can stop the viral load replicase of the disease. So anyways, they ignored the fact that he's 53 years old and has been working out every day of his fucking life and just hit him with this on CNN, like, oh, he's taking horse dewormer and blah, 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 blah. And my man's handled it like a thug, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not sure if it was set up ahead of time or if this came afterwards, but Dr. Sanjay from CNN booked an interview with Joe Rogan because of his new book.
That's what's up.
And if you thought this wasn't going to come up, you're That's sadly fucking mistaken.
And then I just feel like a lot of time, like, do you agree that there's so much fake news that
it's unbelievable
really hard to navigate through the bullshit?
To be honest with you, if you take all the news networks together, you're probably getting 20% of that is actual facts and news.
Yup, that's what I'm saying.
The rest of it is opinions.
There used to be a line of integrity.
Yeah, in the Walter Cronkite days and the motherfucking Dan Brokaw days.
Like, where they was like putting people on blast.
Like journalism, real journalism, where you go with
real journalism. Shout out real journalists.
There ain't very many left.
There ain't very many left.
And look, one of the main reasons these new news networks are mad at Joe Rogan is that they pull in 1.4 million views per video, and he pulls in 200 million. Right. That's half of America, you fucking pieces of shit.
Where
do you think people are going? And by the way, as an avid listener of Joe Rogan, he always says, don't take my advice. I'm a fucking moron. I'm a fucking comedian. My advice to you is don't take my advice.
Right.
Nobody's fucking squeezing horse paste in their fucking mouth, you fucking idiots. You know what I'm saying? This ain't a Donald Trump situation with fucking hydrochloroquine, which we're probably going to get pulled for saying that, too.
Oh, man.
But anyways, man,
yeah,
so...
You can't tell the truth no more.
So he's made his way 360. The dude got from CNN got just reamed in the nicest way. In the most... If it was me, I'd have put my hands on him, bro.
Thanks.
I told Babe, and she was like, you know what? You probably would have. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, I wouldn't have had no cordial discord with the man. We'd have had fisticuffs.
Oh, we shouted out everybody's new projects. Bandit's
Not yet.
New project is coming.
We haven't shouted out everybody yet. You know, So Knight just dropped Not Your Typical MC.
Nope.
Or
Numb
my bad.
Yourself to
Numb
emotion.
Yourself to Emotions, another
Not
acronym.
Not Your Typical MC was the last one.
And Saint B is about to drop Apostolic.
Yep.
I don't know how to say it.
That's how you say it.
Carpe Demos is just assembled, and they're working on something currently right now.
I think
and
it's pronounced apostolic.
Apostolic. I don't fucking know.
Apostolic.
As for us, you know, why is Saint B's name on there twice? As for us, you should already know that we already working on something. We've been working on something, and actually, we've been putting towards this project since the beginning of the year. This has been a long time plan. For almost 9 months, we've planned what we're doing right now. When I can't talk about it, but it's gonna be good. Now, I wanna go here for a minute, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So let's talk, man. What happened to the days when motherfuckers wore Echo jeans and motherfucking Sean John and Rockaware and like just sat in the corner with mean ass faces rapping
Facts.
With big thick ass chains?
Facts.
And then, you know,
I'm gonna tell you what happened.
Pink shirts came around, which is cool, you know what I'm saying?
Fashion,
I rocked them pink shirts.
Fashion and urban wear was always conceptualized by people who didn't wear it. Do that make sense?
It does.
Like, rock all those brands that you named had like somebody suit and tie as fuck wearing ass motherfucker in the boardroom that was pushing the buttons to navigate that vehicle as far as business went. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but I'm pretty
so
sure
we were wearing it. You
none,
know what I'm
none of those signs would have led you to believe that such a thing as Lil Nas X would exist.
Yes and no. Because look, there was a time where Dr. Dre had an album cover with a sharp, sparkly ass dress on, and everybody tried to expose him. But it, when you look like the female in that era, you got the most bitches. Look at Prince.
You ain't joking.
You feel me? Like
that nigga swam a pussy.
Yo, and motherfuckers wore blouses. You heard?
But look.
But yeah,
this little Nas X situation.
The pregnant picture.
Yeah, it's a
as
lot.
As a man, it's a lot. It's a lot.
You know, I almost looked past it giving the devil a lap dance, but then the devil got him pregnant.
Yeah, that was a little weird. I get it. You know, artistry is what it is, but it's just what I don't like. Here's the thing that I don't like, because I don't give a damn if you suck dick, eat pussy, eat ass, you fuck pans.
Suck my dick.
If you fuck pans and pots, I don't know.
I'm pansexual.
You know what I'm saying? If you know what I'm saying? If you fuck animals, that's a little weird. I still can't judge you. Do your thing.
I won't judge you, but
I'll feel
your
vagina. You know what I'm saying? Shit, OnlyFans is a thing. I've just heard of bitches putting ridiculous things in their pussy. Like,
but see,
you
the,
know what
the,
I mean?
We're the
it's whatever. But
where the weird part is,
I don't want my kids to have to deal with that yet. You know what I mean? Like, just let them
I get that.
Navigate life without having to know SpongeBob's gay. Nobody gave a fuck back then. Like, we didn't watch Batman because he was kissing Catwoman. We watched it.
Nobody really cared what
ass,
Batman,
you know,
was doing.
Saying? Yeah, like, we just wanted to see Batman. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a cartoon. Like, we did that to escape the reality shit.
So,
you know,
with the Lil Nas X part, the part where he doesn't fit is lyrical content.
No, but, not at all. He's not lyrical at all.
Like, if he was gay and held it down for gay rappers, we couldn't argue here.
Shout out Frank Ocean. He's not a rapper, but he's gay and a singer, and his voice is beautiful.
I bet
so
you
is
it
Sam
is.
Sam Smith.
I bet
real,
you it is. But
real
see,
beautiful voice.
Lyricism, look, it's a meritocracy, bro. There's no men or women or gay or whatever.
Nah,
it's if you're dope, you're dope.
You dope.
And we
judge
you by your skill. It's a meritocracy.
Facts. Yep.
And he's not. You know what I'm saying? What's that Old Town Road? That shit was a fucking throwaway. Like I'm glad he got his money off of it, and a lot of people probably was feeling that shit.
Yeah, he's successful from it.
Yeah, but the what's the same? Call Me by Your Name or whatever. That shit, dog shit. The music sucked. The video was entertaining because come on, you know what I'm saying? What the fuck is going on? But then his next video,
it kind of looked like Lil Nicky.
His next music video was The Sound of Music in a prison.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It was the gayest thing you've ever seen.
With Jack Harlow on it.
Yeah, and I don't know. It's just so weird. And word through the grapevine is that Lil Nas X is going to be on Joe Rogan Experience soon. So ooh. I'm going to reserve my judgments for him as a person because I don't really know much about him.
I don't either, to be honest.
I'm just judging about his music, and I'm not a fan of the music
and
itself.
I'm pretty much in tune with a lot of things.
And as shocking as the videos are, I'm kind of a fan of the videos because of how shocking they are. You're going to get people
shock
talking.
Value. Yeah, shock value.
Like, I love Marilyn Manson, and that man is every rumor you could possibly think has been spread about that man. Mm-hmm. Everybody thinks he sucks dick.
Right.
But meanwhile, he's been married to nothing but actresses and models his whole fucking career.
I did not know that. You put me up on that shit.
Yeah, that boy knee-deep in pussy at all times, bro. He's always got some fine-ass bitch.
But that's just like my man's Lenny Kravitz.
Right. You would think Lenny Kravitz has some like little light-skinned dude with him. No, that dude.
My whole life.
That dude bouncing them booties, bro.
And he bouncing ass, bro.
So, I mean, what can you say?
Dennis Rodman.
Dennis Rodman, he's a character, though. He's one of those dudes, you can put him in a lineup and nobody looking like him. Nobody stands out like that
he's
dude.
He's definitely Dennis Rodman, for sure.
And it's not the black person with the blonde hair either. It's just his entire aura.
Danny, what you think about Lil Nas X, Danny?
Yeah, what's your opinion?
What you got?
No?
Not a fan.
Not a fan?
What you think about his C-3PO outfit at the...
I died laughing when I seen that.
Is he little? Is he Lady Nas Nas
or whatever?
Lil Nas Nas.
Oh, it was horrible.
Imagine this, Danny. Imagine this. Imagine Lil Nas X and Lady Gaga same stage.
Bro, he wants a song with Lady Gaga.
You haven't seen this much fucking clickbait. Oh, she's gonna come out wearing an entire horse.
Yo, okay, since we're on the topic of, you know, what's acceptable in hip-hop, let's switch topics, but at the same time touch on something. MGK.
Oh my God.
Is running his sucks, boy.
Bro, how do you go? All right, you got Eminem kicked you out of hip hop.
Uh huh.
So you start punk rock.
Talk to him.
You get on stage and you diss.
He actually did pretty good at Slipknot.
And you picked the worst vague ass thing to diss them on. Like, if you're just like, Corey Taylor's a little bitch, you'd be like, oh, okay. Well, nobody would have been like super mad. But when you're like fucking Slipknot on stage, 50 years old with masks, you pissed off an entire, including Tech N9ne.
I hope that happens. Can we play Herder on the Cthulhu Caverns?
We can, but all he did is burn bridges. He didn't
do, live reacts, baby.
Yeah, he did not. Actually, we are gonna play this while we're talking still.
Live reacts, Herder, H-E-R. Yeah.
Do I know how to spell it? I listened to the whole album, fool.
Oh, I ain't know.
Back to back twice.
Nice.
The last two songs that suck, though.
Fear exodus, love you, Tech, but... Everything you do
Tech,
in this
answer this
world
for me.
Ran hold by on. Fearmongers the album, and man? Their followers will why seem extremely stupid.
What the fuck is Zaza and Close Your Eyes? Fuck them songs.
Haven't you heard the hull of the murder from all that I served you, giving your words to wake and disturb you? Yes, I got the nerve to get them all perturbed if they don't concur, but I know we deserve to speak in reserve. The moniker referred to me as the herder.
The goaded, by the people when they hear Tech in his coded, switching with the gears, getting this molded to give him a severe flex, then it's loaded with so many rhyme tricks.
Because of a nine spit, I designed the one of a kind shit. Rhyme for rhyme, I gun up a nine quick. They find a shine when confronted with mine, bitch.
Even with a slow flow, I make folks go like they breaking stools. Blokes chose to play breaking rule, cause those bros show I take them too. Another level, and they would never settle for any old joke to write blazing jewels. So dope, but in a joke, the herder, cause the coach knows that I make a move.
He knows that he got everything to serve ya. No hella repeat enough to push you further.
We must
try and go for greatness, get the words done. Make him say,
Jesus.
The herder. He knows that he got everything to serve ya. No hella repeat enough to push you further.
We must
try and go for greatness, get the words done. Make him say,
Jesus.
Not a cap. They know when he's packing a shot of strap. When so many rappers kicking a lot of crap. But when I'm up on it, they know they gotta rap. Cause they know there's a flow sick and knowing the tech I never unload if the bogus. So they gotta come with some of the dopest aerobics.
Cause I'm giving them with as cold as the COVID.
Imagine when I sit so fragile to the K dot and spray boxes meant to rattle. When I stay dropping A lot, he's into dabble. MGK got my crave up and went to battle
with an introduction that needs none. But he represents the D sun from the Midwest. You know, we come. Look at what he did when I sent him speed down. So I'm not the one to rival. Look how I made Tiago on the Bible. Push Joyner on Serato won the title. Try the herder and his ghost is fucking homicidal. He knows
come
that
on,
he
man.
Got everything to serve ya.
Understood, ain't gotta be explained.
Look, there is, Tech N9ne had a couple disappointing drops for me as a big Tech N9ne fan. He's always been my favorite rapper. But this was as refreshing as music to be murdered by. You know what I'm saying? I was pleasantly surprised to hear an Eminem album that I didn't have to skip many.
Right.
Actually, I didn't skip any. I heard them all on both albums. On Tech's album, too. I listened to everything all the way through, whether I was a big fan of it or not. And in the end, Asinine only had two songs on it. I can't fuck with.
Not to even cut Tech N9ne short, because that album was good. But you heard that Nas, that King Disease 2?
I've only heard a select few songs out there. I was never really a super big Nas fan, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's
lyrically dope, but he's not.
He's gotta be a cup of tea, you know what I mean?
Yeah, he's lyrically dope. He's metaphorically profound, but he's just not there where I want him to be with wordplay and technique. He's one of the greatest. He's a GOAT. I will not deny him that. But you know, I prefer, if you had to give me a choice, I'm clicking on Big L or Big Pun. You know what I'm saying? Anybody else in that era with the just right. Better rhyme schemes.
Yeah,
and the fact
like
that he didn't go after Lil Nas X for the name thing, I got a beef with it.
Nah, he did a song with him.
Well, then he'd have lost my respect completely.
He did it before the whole crazy gay move.
Yeah, well, I bet he regrets that shit now. I hope he got himself a pair of blood shoes. Yeah, that motherfucker gave you 0.1 milliliters of AIDS.
Dead.
So, yeah. All right, now before we're going to have to get thick right quick. We got to talk about this. It's got to be talked about, because if Cthulhu Caverns existed when that time came, we would have been talking about it then. But can we just talk about the absolute botch of Afghanistan? Jesus, yeah, fucking a lot Christ! Going on, man. Look, my cousin David Harley, if he's hearing this right now, he knows how I feel, man. I feel you, bro. But he spent 17 years. He wasted 17 years in Afghanistan, chasing whatever the fuck the government said to do. You know what I'm saying? Yep. And pretty much everything that he did in his entire career got reversed in less than 3 hours. 17 years, 3 hours. 17 years, 3 hours. All right, when we showed up there, they were in flip-flops throwing rocks with old Soviet Union equipment left behind. We just left them an army supply. We just left them Blackhawks, tanks, RVs, $85 billion worth of guns and grenades and night vision.
Dang.
Bro, when we go back there, it's going to be like fighting a modern army. It's not about to be no easy shit. These motherfuckers got Barrett 50 cals now.
What did we do over there when the whole Bin Laden shit happened? I thought it wasn't no more problems. Now we back over there. You know what? America got the worst damn...
We have a tendency of getting everybody's shit.
Yeah. It's a need to get involved in everybody's business. Well, look, y'all like the nosy-ass neighbor that keep looking out the blinds regardless.
See, we're the we're technically the anti-bully that doesn't know we're actually a bully.
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying?
Why the fuck we over there when we got a billion homeless over here?
Well, I'll tell you why we're there. It goes way far back, but it was because of George Bush Sr.
Yep.
He had plenty of disputes with oil over there, and he couldn't get everything fixed by the time he left office, so he had to wait for Bill Clinton to go through.
We got so many different avenues of clean energy now, though. Like, we got.
I mean, look, if you think I'm lying, you could look into it, but it's pure facts. But it actually, nuclear plants cost way less to the environment. Radioactive waste is easier manageable, because all right, so with all the gas and coal and all the things that we have to use to run our electrical grid now.
Facts.
All right, you guys, I'm sure nobody here knows what the fuck over Unity is, but so what we do is under Unity, we pump in 100% energy into the grid. And we only get back about 60% of what we put in to go to the energy grid. So over Unity would be you get 100% out of 100%. So with nuclear power plants, you're more 87% out of the 100% you drop in at, rather than 60. So it costs way less effort and environmental damage to run a nuclear facility that can power multiple cities. And everybody just hears the word nuclear and they just, no. But technically, it's way cleaner. You know what I'm saying? And the radioactive rods, the fuel rods, you could put them all inside of a barrel. Actually, I just heard somebody say this today. You could take all of the entire world's nuclear waste and fit it into one football field. Look at all the trash. We got an island of trash that's the size of like Manhattan floating around the fucking ocean.
Just pour some nuclear waste on it.
Nah, that's not gonna work. But
get rid of it.
I mean, there's so many more options. You know, a while back in the 70s and it had a resurgence in the 90s, they were talking about zero point energy, which is basically building a generator that can absorb gravity converted into electricity. Gravity doesn't run out, it's infinite.
Hell yeah.
But that's going to lose a lot of people a lot of money. So that never happened. A guy named James Walsh in Ohio invented a car engine that could go 170 miles off of 16 ounces of water. Guess what happened to him? Dead in 2 weeks after his news broadcast.
Dang.
Hit by a black SUV in traffic. What happened to his garage?
Who drives black SUVs?
What happened to his garage while everybody's at his funeral? Gets burnt down. All evidence lost.
Would you look at that?
Well, fucking Nikola Tesla.
Shout out my boy Snowden.
Nikola Tesla. He said, all right, I'm going to give everybody free energy. He was dead, penniless in a hotel.
Dr. Sebi said he could cure everything from AIDS to thing with vegetables. Dead.
Nipsey Hussle. He said, I can show these hood motherfuckers how to go from drug dealing to entrepreneuring. Dead. You know what I'm saying? Bob Marley. He said, man, fuck all that shit. I'm about peace. Let's get together and gather and have... Dead. You know what I'm saying? Fucking... from the Beatles.
John Lennon.
John Lennon's like, hey, let's all stop arguing, come together and have like peaceful conversations. Dead. Does she sleep? Come on. So it's just we had to get that political shit out of the way. It's got to be done.
Facts.
Where's my dignity?
Your dignity? I thought you left that in the house. All right. So now I think we already touched on Bismarcky while Cthulhu Caverns was still a thing, but I do have to say rest in peace, man. 2021 was that was pretty rough.
Norm Macdonald.
Now I'm going in backward. I'm going in order of dopest. Norm Macdonald. I wasn't a super big fan of his actual stand up.
But, oh no, I loved him in all the movies though.
Yeah, as an actor stand-up. And as like just a personality on like news channels or in like the Man Show and shit like that. He was funny as fuck, bro. He got away with bashing women for so long.
Facts.
And obviously it was all a fucking joke, but
right.
He was so good at it. He would piss people straight the fuck off.
And he was a calm dude.
Like
very, very, in
one episode of his show on Man Show, he mentioned Jennifer Aniston's breasts like 19 times, and each time it was funny. I was like, like, how do you do that many times?
We're about
2 minutes late for a Jennifer Aniston titty joke. Bam, there it goes. Now, the hardest one for me, man, Michael K. Williams, bro. Dude, yeah. Omar.
Rest in peace, Michael K. Williams. Omar was one of my favorite
fucking characters, man, because look, he reminded me of somebody I knew from the hood named Dre. All right, so Omar was gay, had a boyfriend and all that. But he was the absolute most feared tyrannical monster walking the streets with a shotgun.
Yep.
If you seen fucking...
The Wire.
Yeah, if you seen The Wire and you seen Omar hitting the corner,
you know
get the fuck in the house, running, hide the drugs. Word. He's coming. He's a the drug Wire. Dealer. Rapper. What a good show.
Yeah, that shit was good.
All right, now while we're still on celebrities, let's talk about this The Rock verse on fucking Tech N9ne CD.
Uh-oh.
What the fuck?
He went off, bro. I liked it.
Can the man?
It was a few haters.
Can the man not do anything? Like, dude, Jesus Christ! Of course, there's haters, but the fact that he's not a rapper.
He
did Moana.
He
did Moana. Moana had like a little bit of rap element.
Yeah, a little rap in it, but not very much.
But I bet you that like inspired him to like, you know what? Maybe I can write some music.
Yeah, Tech did a live stream before the video dropped and was talking about how he talked to The Rock about it, and he was like, "I was just expecting him to talk some shit." Like, I sent it to him, and I was like, yo, just talk some shit on the end. And all of a sudden, he called Tech back. It was like,
I want to
snap on some shit. And he was like, what? You know what I'm saying? And you already know, Tech got some heavy hitters on that boy. Like, for me, I'm going to be honest, The Rock shit was nice, but Joey Cool, bro, that verse was
Joey Cool
hard,
actually did
dog.
Kill it. I'm not a super big fan of Joey Cool, but that verse
bitch,
was one of his
bro.
Hardest. Especially the hit him with the left, hit him with the right, and he's stumbling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, then he comes back and does it again. I'm like, okay, I like that. That was dope.
Man, he went off on that bitch. Yeah, period.
All right, so now, before we're going to come
and
to a close here soon.
King Iso went hard.
We're going to come here to a close soon. You know, I don't want to make this too long, but it's already been 38 minutes. So, but we're going to save the top one for last.
One more.
All right, we got three more things to discuss. Number one, the new Call of Duty coming out, Vanguard. Come on, bro. Who the fuck is going to be in the lobby with me getting smacked up?
Because I don't know.
I played the beta, bro, and I already know some of the maps. I'm about to fucking smear y'all.
It's about to be like World War II all over, though.
It is, but it's better. The graphics are better. The guns are better.
All right, we're going to see, I guess.
And the zombies. There was no zombies in World War II that's worth talking about. Like, that shit was just one level of who gives a fuck.
I guess, yeah.
But this new Vanguard, they're running off a new engine, so everything's supposed to be so much more crispy. They're running off the same engine as Diablo is.
Ooh.
And you already, if you guys have seen the Diablo 4 previews,
It's on PC already. They got it.
Diablo 4? Oh, okay. Yep. Well, it's coming to consoles, and the engine that they ran it off of is just so fucking crispy, bro. And Call of Duty's running off the same engine, so it's about to be like, you'll be able to see the crazy pores in their shit, face. Bro. The fucking lighting's about to be beautiful. Now, in the beta, just like every beta, there's a little bit of bad shit. You know what I'm saying? The guns are a little clacky. Your footsteps sounded too loud, but... For a beta it was the best beta out of Cold War World or Modern Warfare.
Cold War's beta. It wasn't bad.
It wasn't bad, but it was all over the place. The only complaint I really have, and is probably my internet, is how laggy I was.
Yeah, see, mine wasn't laggy. I just know that like a lot of people's shit was taking a minute to pop up. Like it'd be a dude running around and his gun wasn't there right away. You know what I'm saying? Huh. And then you would like go back and his shit was fixed.
And then while we're on the topic of Call of Duty, I'm glad that they brought back the grav, but I'm mad that they brought it back at the last season when everybody's about to switch games. Because the grav is a good gun.
They know some people was about to not switch games.
I don't know. I think that they're, because that gun was OP in Black Ops 4, so I'm 100% sure that they're like, people are going to complain about this.
That's the Galil, essentially.
Yes,
right?
It used to be called the Galil, but now it's called the grav.
Yeah.
Now the next thing we're going to talk about is coming soon. If you guys listening to Numb Yourself to Emotion, then you might have heard the song Villain.
Yeah, we working on a video, man. No, we working on a movie.
Yeah,
we're working on a motion picture.
It is going to be nice.
It's going to be a little D-League or B-movie. Little B-movie, you know what I'm saying?
But hey, coming from some people without any equipment, you know what I'm saying? We got a 4K camcorder, a Coolpix B500, and a couple cell phones.
I'm gonna just give you the premise because this is Cthulhu.
No. All right, you know what? All right, it is Cthulhu Caverns.
It's the Cthulhu Caverns.
Give him a piece.
I'm gonna literally tell you like this: if you could picture this, you could see what it's about to be. What if Joker got Thanos' glove, linked up with Deadpool, and snapped?
Oh boy! Pure death.
Villain.
Yeah, so Villain is about to be, it's about to be something fun.
That's it. You know what I'm saying?
It's the first time.
And I'm a nerd, so I had to.
It's my first time being killed on film.
Nerd Nation. Oh, it looks so good, too. He died so well.
I died pretty well. My neck hurts from all the takes. No, I'm just kidding. All right, but last but not least, I had to save this one for last because this one is going to be fun, bro. So let's rewind back a little bit before we get into my man's right here.
Here we go.
So,
I don't even want to talk about this duckhead ass dude.
Oh, he gets to talk. All right, so. So, King Iso, he said, you know what? I'm sick of all the bullshit with brain sick. Fuck off. I'm done. Tech9's like, well, come on over, buddy. And of course, Twisted Insane turns into the biggest fucking hater on the planet. And it started with Whitney Payton. Whitney Payton dropped the thing with Iso.
It was like a remix.
And
he was like, I can't fuck with Whitney no more.
And Knight got on there and was like, who gives a fuck? Go take your stupid faggoty ass back to your crib. Dude, shut the fuck up.
Anyway, I got reported.
Uh-huh. And that was it. He didn't respond to him.
That was it. I didn't say nothing.
No. Then, Twisted Insane didn't like mention Knight this time. He just was like, where that report came from.
Yeah, for sure. I went hard. I think I tagged him too.
Now, who was it this time?
It was literally on a post of, or on a video of his. I said, like, I feel like you a biter.
No, I mean, who was it responsible for? There's another person that he, like, commented on.
Oh, damn, man. I don't know for sure. I want to say it was, like, one of Iso's dudes, like Tabo or something like that. But it could have been Kung Fu Vampire.
Kung Fu Vampire.
I follow
a few
different dudes. You know what I'm saying?
It was like, for sure Kung Fu Vampire.
They did songs with Iso. So it could have been Ajax. I forget his name. Awax.
It was for sure Kung Fu Vampire.
But either way, it was a post involving King Iso. Again, here we go again. And he ate it again. Like, yo, I don't remember what he said on this one.
Now, last time we had these on reserve, Knight commissioned me to make a picture of Twisted Insane hugging a fucking 12-inch, or no, like a 5-foot-long cock.
Yeah,
and then we changed brain sick music to gay dick music and jammed one down his throat. And I messaged those to King Iso and to Twisted Insane, and he commented them with his ballsy ass.
Yeah.
And yeah, so Knight got attention from Twisted Insane. They went back and forth a couple few times because he caught his ass biting.
I will say this, because he had said, are you the type of man who's just going to pop shit or you going to do the research? Blood. And I was like, look, I ain't even on no gangster shit.
Right, you calling me the wrong name, get fucking punched in the mouth over this way.
I go ahead and,
bitch.
You know what I'm saying? Like, go do the research. So I watch both of their videos. I watch all the little camp videos, too. And I told him the same thing I'm going to say right now on Cthulhu Caverns. All y'all just sound like some niggas who missed the homies. Like, y'all got really mad at the homies, and y'all separated, and you miss them.
Now, and I'm going to go ahead and say this.
I've been in that position. Maybe y'all should make up. Get right, you know what I'm saying? Like,
hey, look, as the host of Cthulhu Caverns, I'm and as the ugly member of the Bearded Weirdos, let me say this. Fuck you, Twisted Insane. You're garbage. We performed with you, and you're fucking shit. You're like Magic Mike B-movie version the whole time with your little chair on the stage spinning around, sticking your tongue out at a bunch of dudes. Like, you're garbage. Like, your music... All you are is noise. It's all filler. I read your lyrics.
Been writing from the 90s.
All right, now I'm gonna give you the one props that you can do triple time. But when you read the lyrics, you ain't saying shit, bro. Just like everybody else, I twist as well. Guess what? I'll tell you what. Most of the time, I ain't saying shit either. I am. I try my best. I don't try to use filler. I try to go out of my way to make sure that everything's consistent. And if you read it, it makes a lot of sense. I don't think you do that. I think you're like, ah, it fits, and it's good. Also, you stole King Iso's verse for So Dope, so fuck
you. He said he stole that from him.
Nope, I went back and I looked at that song, and it came out 2 years before he met fucking Twisted Insane. So you're a lie. You do your own research. Research your own fucking shit, you stupid faggot.
Cthulhu Caverns,
I literally hope that the Pichu climbs up your fucking dick when you piss in the Amazon River, bitch. You know what I'm saying? I hope your kids got COVID. Mm. I love your kids, but fuck you. You know what I'm saying? And I hope your kids get mad gifts for Christmas too from your baby mama's current boyfriend. You know what I'm saying? Because you ain't worth a fuck, bro. I hope your mama's boyfriend outdo you by like 20 degrees. You know what I'm saying, bro? You ain't worth fucking shit. So I need you to go home and kill yourself, okay?
So that's what happened with that beef.
Yeah, so I need you to go home,
dig music, bro.
Dig under your counter, take anything that says do not ingest, and ignore the label. All right? I need you to...
Drink that shit.
I need you to find the Rock and headbutt his pelvis with your mouth open, all right? Because he just did a song with fucking King Iso. You gonna say something about him? Because he'll tear you in half. And I'd pay to see it. So with that being said, fuck Twisted Insane. I hope your rest of your year goes garbage, and I hope you make no music at all. I hope that your microphones all break, you piece of shit. So suck a dick, fuck you, and I love you, fans. Welcome back if this gets uploaded, and if we don't get pulled for mentioning ivermectin.
He does it again at the end just to make sure.
Hydrochloroquine. You can say it three times, Dr. Fauci will appear.
That was good.
Oh yeah, no, that was good. I'm glad
we're
I came up with that one.
On that note, for sure.
Oh, that was a good freestyle though. All right, see you guys later. Peace.